Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a special tag team match. First from Trenton, Georgia, in the ring at 228 pounds, Pat Rose. His partner is from the outer galaxy. This is the Galaxian. Their opponents are in the ring area, representing the Four Horsemen from Minnesota at a combined total weight of 516 pounds, Arn and Ole Anderson.
The Andersons representing the Horsemen, getting a great ovation. It was great to see those guys. For many of the fans, this past Wednesday night, and Pat Rose starting out. What's he has something in his hand. He has something in his hand. That's a pair of pliers. But to no avail. Look at Double A. There's one he was hit with, a pair of pliers, for goodness sakes. Did Gary Hart hand him those pliers?
I'm not going to terminate myself, Jim.
I think it was Gary Hart that... Well, I'll tell you something, that's a desperation move.
Well, there's nothing pretty about them black tights, black wrestling jackets, no music, but this is what it's all about. On a marquee, it says wrestling, Jim.
Nobody does it better, no one has done it better in tag team wrestling than the Andersons. Started out with Ole and Gene, it progressed to Ole and Arn now. And there's nobody any better in the country than these two.
The teamwork as tag teams, the thing about them that I like the most, you talk about viciousness, you talking about giving no quarter, you talk about taking no quarter, the Andersons are all men.
Boy, indeed they are. There is no doubt that they are all business. You know, George Halas said one time that the team that blocks and tackles the best wins the game. So what he said is the team that's most fundamentally sound is going to win the contest. No team in wrestling is any more fundamentally sound in tag team wrestling than the two men, the Andersons, that we're seeing here today.
I can't say it any better, Jim. You get it on the nose. You know your sports. It's like throwing a pass when these guys fly in the air. Three things can happen in a pass and two of them are gone. They keep her on the ground, they establish a winning game, and that's how you score. That's how these guys score. Driven hard right up the middle.
That's how my friend Barry Switzer did it for years in Oklahoma, running that wishbone. They ran it right down their throats, and that's what... Oh, it comes! That spine buster! And that is his move. That is his signature move.
I'd like to see him apply that to Buzz Sawyer, the great Muta, or the Dragon Master.
Pat Rose in there to prevent the pin, nailing Arn Anderson. Rose with all the offense he can humanly muster. Anderson is taking it. He hasn't even gone down. He blocked the... Ooh, he blocked the snare mirror and then delivered a thunderous elbow right to the back of the head, and a tag is made. They tag so quickly, so crisply.
They keep that ring cut in half. They keep the man in their half the ring. They make a block on a tag, and look it, they get in the ropes. They know how to use the rope. Only this is basic. He's hurting this guy's got his wind. Look at hands in the face, knee in the back, elbow to the back of the neck. This hurts. Everything they do.
He rubs that forearm right across the face in a front face lock-like maneuver. Now he's working on the arm of Pat Rose. Boy, they'll pick out one body part now. They've gone as far as they're going to go. They're going to pick out one body part. And they're going to...
This is vintage Anderson. They're going for the arm. They're weak in the arm. Next thing you'll see, they'll put it behind the back, and they'll stop slamming.
Well, I'll tell you what, that is their M.O. Ole Anderson came back to join forces with Ric Flair for Halloween Havoc on October 28th. And then last Saturday, right here in World Championship Wrestling, the surprise. You're seeing that surprise in the ring now with a very wide base, with the arm bar, taking the shoulder against the grain.
And keeping them on their side of the ring. No chance for a tag. They're making the life miserable for Pat Rose right now. They're making it so miserable that if he lasts another 3 minutes, I'll be very, very surprised.
I would concur with that. Fans, don't forget, the big Christmas week, the biggest week of the year for the NWA. Over 30 of the greatest stars in the sport live. Christmas Day at 2 in Greenville, Christmas night at 8 in Charlotte, the 26th in Knoxville, the 27th in Philadelphia, the 28th in Baltimore, December 29th in the Richmond, Virginia Coliseum, and ending on the 30th of December in the Greensboro Coliseum. Right back here in Atlanta, and brother, it will be red hot on New Year's night in the Omni.
It certainly will, and I'll break every New Year's resolution, New Year's night that I made New Year's Day, because I'll be right along with you, Jim Ross.
It's going to be a big New Year's Eve here for all of us in Atlanta. But then, because the next night we're going to be in the Omni, right there. Look at the wide base.
It's what we talked about before. He hurts you every which way. The Andersons like to hurt you, and they do it basically. They do it in wrestling. They've stayed on the sound, and here's what I said. He's going to slam him, and this is vintage Anderson at its finest.
Slamming him on that arm. We may not see the Galaxian again in this match.
I will guarantee you we will see the Galaxian again this night. If I was Pat Rose, I'd say yes, I'd give up. But I'm not Pat Rose, and I would never give up.
But he did.
Here are your winners, Arn and Ole Anderson!
They represent the Horsemen. And we will talk to them in a moment with Nature Boy Ric Flair, but we will take another look at the carnage.
The captain of the team, Ole, gets up, high, drives it right in deep. He's going to hook the arm. Pat Rose, you should have given up 3 minutes ago, and it disallowed all that pain.
Welcome back to World Championship Wrestling, Arn.
Well, Jim Ross, I've been all across this country in the last year, and all the conversations I had were the same. How's Rick? Where's Ole? They say adversity introduces a man to himself. Well, the Horsemen have been through a lot of adversity. There's been some name changes. There's been a few discrepancies within the family. But we always knew family is still family. We may smack each other, but Sawyer, Hart, Muda, Dragon Master, you want to smack us, you got to pay the fiddler.
There you hear from the Horsemen, ladies and gentlemen.